Hi, this is Sachin Bhatnagar, and welcome to this screencast on creating a product turntable using JavaScript. A product turntable allows you to showcase and present your product in a unique way. As you can see here, we have an air cooler unit being presented as a turntable. Once the turntable loads up, the image of the air cooler rotates, giving us a 360-degree view of the device. This gives a much better view of a product than static photographs. And therefore, a product turntable feature is extremely valuable for online shopping sites and product review sites. For creating a turntable, you can get the product photographed from all sides as it rotates on a physical turntable. This way, you should end up with about 60 images of the product. We generally use 60 images for a product turntable because that way we have about 4 seconds of animation running at 15 frames per second. Anything lower than 60 images would not result in a smooth enough playback. Alternatively, we can also create these images using a 3D animation software like Autodesk Maya or 3ds Max. These images of the air cooler unit were in fact rendered in Autodesk 3ds Max. When creating an animation from a 3D software, you should ideally choose to render out the animation at about 15 frames per second. Our script is divided into two parts. The preloader first loads and caches all the images, and the player then plays the animation by looping over the image sequence at 15 frames per second. So let's get started. This is the HTML page that we have created for this project. There is an image tag which currently shows a static image of the air cooler unit. We also have a progress bar which is simply made up of two divs. The folder structure for this project contains a CSS style sheet, the main index.htm file, a folder for the JavaScript file that we'll create, and the actual image sequence which has been kept in the images folder. Note the file naming convention here. There is a file name followed by the frame number and the image extension. So in our HTML file, the first thing that we will do is create a script tag that points to our turntable.js file. As you can see, we are also using jQuery for this project, and the same has already been loaded in. Let's create the turntable.js file now. We'll save that in the JS folder. And let's create a function called turntable that accepts a file path to the image sequence that we want to play as the turntable. So let's actually start creating some variables. The first variable would be known as turntable img, and this would point to the image tag that will display the turntable on the page. The next variable would be called as progress bar element, and this would point to the progress bar div that we will show on the page. While we are at it, we will also create a variable called progress bar max, which will find out the width of the parent div within which our progress bar sits. Because when we animate the progress bar from 0 to 100%, we need to know the width of the parent div within which the progress bar sits. Next, we'll create a variable called endFrame, which will be set to 59 because our image sequence runs from 0 to 59. We'll create a variable called FramesLoaded, and we're going to set it to 0. This variable would be used by the preloader part of our script to count the frames as they are loaded in. We will also create an array which will hold references to all the frames that are loaded in. Now we'll write our main function, which we'll call tableRun, which accepts an argument called preload, which decides whether to continue caching the frames in or to play the animation. Now let's write the preloader. Since we have to loop over all frames as we load them in, we'll check to see if the value of the variable FramesLoaded is less than or equal to endFrame. If so, then we'll set the value of the array frames with an index set to frames loaded to a new image object. We will then set the source property of this image object to the path of the frame that we wish to load in. Let's write a function called createPath here, which will create that path for us by passing in the frame number, which is essentially the value of the variable frames loaded. The createPath function simply concatenates the value of the filePath variable with which we will invoke the turntable function in the first place with the value of the frames loaded and the file extension. We are using a ternary operator to prefix an additional 0 should the frame number be below 10. This is because the first 10 files of the image sequence are numbered from 00 to 09. Next, let's create an onload listener on our image object to see if the frame has indeed been cached in. If so, it's time to animate the progress bar. To do that, we will first calculate the width value of the progress bar based on the number of frames that have been loaded in. This is done by dividing the frames loaded value by the end frame and multiplying it with the maximum width value of the progress bar element. Then we simply set the width of the progress bar by using the jQuery width method and providing it with the value which we just calculated. Once this is done, it's time to increment the value of the frames loaded variable by 1, followed by invoking the table run function once again with the argument set to true. Setting the argument to true will cause the preloader portion of the table run function to be invoked again. Once the value of frames loaded exceeds the value of end frame, it's time to hide the progress bar by fading out its parent div. We will then invoke the table run function yet again, only this time setting the argument to false. By doing so, the table run function will no longer run the preloader and instead will play the animation sequence. Let's now create a variable called frame counter, which will be used to count the frames as we animate them. We will then use the setInterval function to repeatedly set the source attribute of the turntable image element to a dynamically created path to the frame that we wish to play. The path is generated here using the createPath function, which we created earlier, and providing it with the value of the frame counter variable. Now, since setInterval is going to repeatedly run its callback function, we will check to see if the value of frame counter is less than end frame. If that is the case, we will increment the frame counter by 1, which will cause the next image in the sequence to be loaded in when the setInterval loops. If not, we simply reset the value of frame counter to 0, causing the animation to continuously loop endlessly. Now let's set the frequency at which the setInterval will loop. To do that, we will simply divide 1000 milliseconds by frame rate. Let's create the variable frame rate as well and set it to 15. By doing so, we will achieve an animation frame rate of 15 frames per second. All right, now that this function is ready, we need to kickstart it when our script loads for the first time. The easiest way to do that is to encapsulate the table run function in parentheses like so, and passing in the argument as true, which will invoke the preloader. This method of self-executing a function is known as an immediately invoked function expression, or an IFE. One final thing before we run our script is to ensure that the progress bar unit fades in when the script is called for the first time. This is done by using the jQuery fade in method on the parent div of the progress bar div element. Okay, time to test run our turntable. Let's go back in our HTML file and create a script tag. Let's also create a jQuery ready method to ensure that our turntable script is invoked only when the entire page has been loaded and rendered. Then we'll invoke our turntable function passing in the file path to the image sequence. Note that the file path ends in the file name minus the frame number and extension. This is because the createPath function dynamically completes the file name appending the frame number and the extension as needed in the script. Let's save the file and refresh our HTML page in the browser. And there you go. Our turntable runs as expected. The progress bar shows up for a very brief instance since I am running this script locally on my workstation. Do note that you have to run this project from within a server environment like Apache, or else the files may not load up as expected. So let's summarize. We first need to have about 60 images captured from 360 degrees around the product. Our script has two parts, a preloader, which loads and caches in all the frames by creating a new image object for every frame and using its source property to cache and load the frames in, and a second part, which is the player. The player plays the animation by using setInterval to continually loop through the image sequence that we have stored in the images folder. So go ahead and try creating your very own product turntable using JavaScript. Thank you.